Welcome back to RimWorld. Hippo is still here. Motherfucking psychopath. Some point I may have to hunt him or tame him. I'm not sure which is a better option. Mia and Emily are still sick. They got those sensory mechanites. And they still won't stay in fucking bed. I have noticed a problem with playing RimWorld. There is a particular issue, which is that I find it rather hard to even find myself all that entertaining while playing a game whose entire point is to slowly but surely accomplish a particular goal. That goal being to stand still for very, very long time periods, not really doing anything. As a result, I'm going to have to try and do some things that are at least more interesting and put my entire colony at more of a risk on purpose, specifically for the sake of entertainment, which is something that I know upsets me when I watch people play games. I've never heard them explicitly state that that's exactly what they're doing, so I'm hoping that'll get me a little bit of leeway from you, because if you're going to help me out with that and find it entertaining that I fuck up and might die and then have to restart, then, that'll work out well. So the first thing I'm going to do to try and make this a little more entertaining is directly put my people at risk. But in order to do that, I'm going to need a lot more stone blocks. So I'm going to let them finish doing all this stuff. Hippo. Wait. Why are you allowed in my house? No. You're gonna die now. Everybody, you're all drafted. If nothing else, this cannot continue. I don't like the idea of having to kill that guy, but he won't fucking go. And he even came into my house. That's just not okay. So, all of you need to go. I was luckily able to keep any of these three from having to see the dead body. Witnessed an outsider's death, that's okay. Saw a corpse, not really something I have to deal with. So I'm gonna let them just deal with stuff. New lovers. Julie tried to attract TJ by impishly questioning his punctuality. TJ became aroused and agreed to become Julie's lover. Does that mean they actually like each other now? Because this back and forth has been bothering the shit out of me. They are lovers. They're up to 100. How the fuck did that happen? It doesn't make a lot of sense. They just... Fuck it. It's a good thing I researched all of that furniture and shit, because I need to build them a double bed if they're lovers. I might have the supplies for it. They hadn't put away all that marble, so yeah, I've got enough for it. I'll go ahead and build that. Cargo pods. These dropped plasteel. I need plasteel. Does not seem to deteriorate outdoors, so I can leave it there and it'll be fine. Well, you can deliver marble blocks. That's helpful. And then you can sleep on the goddamn floor. Alright, Julie. You need to prioritize constructing the bed. It's art. That's interesting. This furniture is engraved with an image of a large group of crossbows. The work is infused with the idea of togetherness and is done in a photographic style. Alright, so the two of them are fucking now. That's nice. Starvation. God damn, Mia. 58? You got no excuse. You can bullshit me and say, oh, 708 years old. I just don't know. You're 58 years old. I don't give a fuck about that 758. Or 708. That's stupid. Mia, you may be old, but you are not so old that you don't know how the fuck to feed yourself. I do not accept that. My graveyard is considerably more full than I'd like it to be. I think this system of having the two doors here and the four doors here is actually working better. I'm not entirely sure. I can't be certain of something like that. But I think it is. Caribou migration. It's kind of cool. They're nice sprites. I like the design. Every time I see that thing pop up, it says starvation, and I know it's Mia. But it's kind of sad that she drives herself to starvation. I can't deal with the idea of a boomalope eating my food. That boomalope eating my food, that's not something I could hunt. Especially not while it's near my house. That's fucking dangerous. More cargo pods. What dropped this time? Neutroamine. I need that for making medicine. So I really need to make sure they get that. Getting a lot more meat. I guess it might be a good thing to let animals come up and try to eat my food. Most of the time it's just working as bait. Maybe I can build a little garden right outside where I'm going to put the wall. I ought to put the wall up here, put a place for chunks somewhere over here. Tool cabinet. What's that? Can I make them use tools that are actually appropriate for different stations? That's interesting. Well, I can see that the update did not fix the fact that strangers can just walk into your damn house uninvited. Alright, I'm starting to run lower on steel. Yeah, I gotta research something new. So what should I research? So they added in the tool cabinet, which makes people work faster. That's really helpful for all of these things. I need everything to go a little bit faster. I wonder if it helps the research bench. Oh, I like that. It shows you down here who's going to attack you and everything they feel about you. I'm going to ignore it. Fuck it. I ain't fighting them. I don't need more reasons for more raids. Alright, I just got a message about a mad boomalope, and it happens to be the one that likes to spend time in my fucking garden. Very upsetting to me. I'm gonna have to make sure that nobody goes outside in that direction or in that direction. Nobody's allowed to leave. Alright. Boomalope went the fuck to sleep, so it's okay to leave now. It's okay for that iguana to come in. And I think I can sustain actually having an iguana now. Iggy has a planned bed here, but no one's picked up the camel hide to make it. It takes a while to mine steel. Mining out so much of it is really important for me. Marriage is on. Okay, well, I guess then I need a marriage spot. I don't have anything that looks really nice. So I guess the marriage spot's going to be... I want it to look nice. I don't have anything that looks nice. This is all utilitarian. So we'll have it right there where they eat their food. Well, got a raid. Seems that the cutlasses were upset at me regardless. Vort. See, she is attacking immediately. Alright? Well, then everybody gets drafted. And we're all going there. Just surround her and beat her to death. That works. Shot Emily in the goddamn head. She's going to die in about 10 hours unless she can rest. TJ, you need to tend to Emily because she got shot in the fucking head. Julie, she got shot in the arm. It's not so bad. Julie has created a masterwork camel hide animal bed. Iggy better fucking sleep there too. Oh fuck, it's getting real hot outside, so it's getting real hot inside too. Julie, you have a problem where you tend to give up after breaking a wall down instead of building the thing that needs to be built there. You can't just do that. It's too damn hot outside for that shit. Same fucking thing over there. You know what? You need to finish your work when you start it. God damn it. Alright. Well, I think it's about a good time to actually end the episode. So, I'm going to go and figure out what this ancient danger is. And we'll deal with it together. Whether or not it's something I can actually deal with and survive. So, here's hoping this episode doesn't end in a real bloody mess. Alright, well that wasn't too hard. Seems like this ancient danger I don't need to worry about. That was too anticlimactic, so I'll have to end this episode in a little bit more of a harsh way. Shit. I was gonna be real careful and I was gonna do this all careful and special like, but I guess I ain't doing that. Kill it, kill it, kill it, kill it, kill it. Well, we beat that thing to death. Emily is really hurt. She's gonna die if she doesn't go home. So I'm gonna order her to rest until healed. And, he cannot hit the target. Why can't you hit it? Back. Beat it to death. Beat it to death. Mia, move. How did you miss? He was 3 feet from you. Was less anticlimactic. Now that ancient danger is not entirely dealt with yet, and I understand that. There's still cryptopods in there that have to be dealt with. Up here is finished. I don't have to do anything else. Down here, this stuff could be filled with assholes with guns or a bunch of sick, dead people. It's a decent place to end the episode. I think I'll see you next time.